नमस्ते सेकेंड पी यू सी मैथमेटिक्स आलरे ना डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन डिस्कस नेक्स्ट चैप्टर वेक्टर अलजेब्रा अंत वेक्टर अलजेब्रा सम डेफिनेशन सम रूल्स फर्स्ट वेक्टर्स डेफिनेशन फिजिकल क्वांटिटी कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज ए स्केलर एंड वेक्टर्स So first, what is the meaning of scalar? Scalars, a physical quantity which has the magnitude but not direction, is called scalar. For example, mass, speed, volume, temperature, density, etc. And next definition, vectors, a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction, For examples, weight, velocity, acceleration, etc. Vectors are denoted by directed line segment, that is vector AB, where A is the initial point and B is the terminal point. Thus, vector AB as a vector from A to B. Vector AB can also be represented by vector A. The length of vector AB is magnitude of vector A. Magnitude of vector A is equal to A, where A is the modulus of magnitude of vector A. Next. Types of vectors. First one, unit vector. A vector whose magnitude is unity is called unit vector. Zero vector or null vector. A vector whose magnitude is zero, it is denoted by zero vector. And like and unlike vectors, vector having the same direction are called like vectors. And those having opposite senses of directions are called unlike vectors. Another one definitions, collinear vectors. Two vectors are said to be collinear if they are parallel to the same line. Is called collinear vector. And another one, coincidental vectors. Vectors which have the same initial point are coincidental vectors. Next, coplanar vectors. Vectors in the same plane are called coplanar vectors. Next, direction cosines of a vector. If vector OP makes an angle alpha, beta, gamma with the positive direction of x-axis, y-axis and z-axis here like that, that is the vector OP which makes an angle alpha with respect to x-axis and with respect to y-axis, beta with respect to z-axis, gamma, then cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called the direction cosines of a vector OP and are usually denoted by L, M, N. Here, x, L is equal to LR, y is equal to MR and z is equal to LR. Here, cos alpha is equal to OL by OP adjacent by hypotenuse. That is OL by OP. OP is equal to vector O to the point P divided by vector R. OL is equal to R into cos alpha and again x is equal to R into L. Okay, next, and the direction cosine side. Direction ratio to the three numbers A, B, C which are proportional to the direction cosines L, M, N are called direction ratios. Always direction cosines and direction ratios are always proportional. We have L is equal to direction cosines. L is equal to nothing but equal to cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to A divided by square root of A square plus B square plus C square. And cos beta is equal to L is equal to B divided by square root of A square plus B square plus root of a square plus b square plus c square. And cos gamma is equal to L is equal to c divided by square root of a square plus b square plus c square. The direction ratios of the line joining x1 y1 z1 and x2 y2 z2 are direction ratios of line joining the points, which is the point x1 y1 z1 and x2 y2 z2. Then the direction ratios of this line x2 minus x1 y2 minus y1 z2 minus z1 respectively for the space vectors. Vector R is equal to like that x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. The components of the vectors which are called scalar components, x, y, z are scalar components, and vector components are here x I cap, y j cap and z k cap are called vector components. And scalar product of two vectors, there are two types. One do scalar or dot product, another one vector or cross product. First we are going to scalar or dot product. The dot product vector A and vector B is denoted as vector A dot vector B. That is equal to AB into class vector. Here, A is equal to magnitude of vector A and B is equal to magnitude of vector B, and theta is the angle between the vector A and vector B. So here A and here A is equal to magnitude of vector A. Other the vector A dot B is equal to magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B into class theta. If vector A is equal to A1i plus A2j plus A3k and vector B is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k, then vector A dot B is given by, then the dot product is given by vector A dot B is equal to A1b1 plus A2b2 plus A3b3. Okay, dot product of two vectors is commutative operator, that is A dot B is equal to B dot A. Dot product of two vector is not a vector, but it is a scalar. Vector A dot B is positive or negative according to theta is acute or obtuse. Vector A dot B is equal to 0, cos theta equal to 0, and theta is equal to 90. Vector A is perpendicular to vector B. If vector A is parallel to vector B, then theta is equal to 0 degree. Vector A dot vector B is equal to, vector A dot vector B is equal to, if yavaga vector A is parallel to vector B, then theta is equal to here what? 0. Then vector A dot vector B is equal to magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. If vector A also is equal to vector A dot vector A, vector A dot vector A is nothing but equal to magnitude of vector A whole square. Vector A dot alpha into vector B is equal to a scalar ಓಡಬಹುದು alpha into vector a dot vector b, where alpha is a scalar. And another one property is I dot I is equal to j is equal to k dot k is equal to 1. I dot j dot k, k dot j, so j dot k, I dot k, k dot I is equal to value will be 0. And here find the angle between the vector a and vector b in cosine. Cos of angle ಕೇಳಿದೆ. Cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. Next one, vector product or cross product. Vector product or cross product. The vector product or cross product is defined as vector A cross vector B is equal to magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B into sin theta into n cap. Okay, and number one, vector product is not a commutative property, but dot product is a commutative. Hence, vector A cross vector B is not equal to vector B cross vector A. Not the worry, in general, vector A cross B can be written as minus of vector B cross vector A. Minus sign, because the last two rows are interchangeable. We know that cross product na now define maadi antare, right? Determinant alli ij ka bardu components of vector A barthive second row dalli, third row dalli components of vector B bardu determinant na expand maadidre, that is the enagiddadu product of vector A cross vector B agirutte. And moreover, next, if vector A is parallel to vector B, then vector A cross vector B is equal to 0, then theta is equal to 0 or theta is equal to 180. If vector A is perpendicular to vector B, then vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into n cap. Okay, A into B is magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. For the unit vectors I, j, k, we have I cross j is equal to k cap, j cross k equal to I cap, and k cross I cap is equal to j cap. J cross I is equal to minus k, because cross product is not a commutative. K cross j is equal to minus I, I cross k is equal to minus j, and I cross I, j cross j, k cross k is equal to 0. Next, another one property, scalar triple product is a commutative property. Vector, because scalar triple product is a scalar, hence vector A dot B cross C is equal to vector B cross C dot vector A. Vector A dot B cross C is equal to vector A cross B dot C. Here dot and crosses are interchangeable. Vector A cross vector B dot vector C is not a scalar triple product, and it is not defined. And it is not defined. For that reason, vector A cross B dot C, which is not defined. Okay. A scalar triple product is a zero when any two vectors are same vector. See here, because a scalar triple product vector A dot vector B vector c is equal to 0 then a vector, a vector b and vector c are coplanar. Scalar triple product 0 or only vector a b c are coplanar. Here scalar triple product is 0 when any two vectors are same, because we know that two identical in the determinant, two identical rows or column identical, then the value of the determinant 0, then it is also same. So the scalar triple product na define maadi or expand maadi ante hedre in the determinant where a na coefficient, b na coefficient, c na coefficient, but the determinant na expand maadi, that is the scalar triple product. The scalar triple product represents the volume of the parallel pipe having vector a dot, vector b and vector c as the coterminal sides. A cyclic permutation of the three vectors does not change the value of the scalar triple product. And anti-cyclic permutation of vectors changes the value of the scalar triple product by the sign or its magnitude. Some important idu bittu namu idvarku gelirthakkantha explanation vectors aitu idralle next innond kelavu formulas bartara aa formulas na direct a bandhe helthava if the line joining the points whose position vectors vector a and vector b is divided by a point p in the ratio m is to n, then the position vector of p is vector op is equal to m into vector b plus n into vector a divided by m plus n, and the position of the vector midpoint of vector a and vector b is denoted by vector a plus vector b divided by 2. If the points a b c whose the position vector vector a vector b vector c are collinear, further if b divides a c, b divides a c, then the ratio m is to n, then vector b is equal to m into vector c plus n into vector a divided by m plus n, or m into vector c plus n into vector a minus m plus n into vector b is equal to 0. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, it is a parallelogram. The centroid of a triangle with vectors as vector a, vector b, vector c is centroid of a triangle 1 by 3 into vector a plus vector b plus vector c. And next, the sum of two unit vectors is a unit vector. The magnitude of their difference is root 3. The vector na na sum madidre, that is once again enagirthu unit vector, avugala magnitude na difference is root 3. The projection of vector a and vector b is given by vector a dot vector b divided by magnitude of vector b. Product magnitude of vector b is not equal to 0. Vector a dot vector b plus vector c is equal to Moreover properties, vector a dot vector b plus vector c is equal to vector a dot vector b plus vector a dot c. If vector a plus vector b is equal to magnitude of vector a minus vector b, then vector a and vector b are perpendicular to each other. If vector a and vector b are unit vectors and theta is the angle between them, then sin theta by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 into magnitude of vector a minus vector b. And if vector a and vector b, vector c are three vectors, they form first one an equilateral triangle. Vector a and vector b, vector c are the three vectors, they form an equilateral triangle if and only magnitude of vector a, magnitude of vector b, magnitude of vector c are equal. Moodu enagirbekli equal agirbeku. If three vectors are formed a right angle triangle, if dot product of any these two vectors, you know that two vectors are perpendicular, then the dot product zero. Eradu vector na dot product enagirbeku namge zero agirbeku. Agadre illu kuda statement, if dot product of any two vectors is zero, given three vector forms a right angle triangle. If next one isosceles triangle, if the modulus of any two vectors are equals, you know that in a two sides are equal of the isosceles triangle. Okay, moreover next property, vector a cross vector b plus vector c plus vector b cross vector c plus vector a plus vector c cross vector a plus vector b is equal to 0 agirutte. And next one, magnitude vector a cross vector b, magnitude of vector a cross vector b whole square plus magnitude of vector a dot vector b whole square is equal to a square into b square. If vector a plus vector b plus vector c is equal to 0, then a cross b is equal to b cross c is equal to c cross a agirutte. Okay, next, if vector a, vector b, vector c are changed in cyclic order, vector a, vector b, vector c, vector b, vector c, vector a is equal इक्वल टू वेक्टर सी वेक्टर ए वेक्टर बी ಆಗಿದೆ ಸೈಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆದವರಿಗೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬಹುದು ಸ್ಕೇಲಾರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎ ಕಾಮಾ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಮಾ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ ಚೇಂಜಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಆಂಟಿ ಸೈಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎರಡು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಂಟರ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಂಟರ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಈ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ वेक्टर ए प्लस वेक्टर बी कमा वेक्टर बी प्लस वेक्टर सी कमा वेक्टर सी प्लस वेक्टर ए इज इक्वल टू 2 टाइम्स ऑफ वेक्टर ए वेक्टर बी वेक्टर सी ಆಗುತ್ತೆ इनइक्वालिटी मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए डॉट बी इज लेस देन आर इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए डॉट मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी ಆಗುತ್ತೆ एंड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए प्लस वेक्टर बी इज लेस देन आर इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए प्लस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी ट्रायंगुलर इनइक्वालिटी मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए माइनस वेक्टर बी इज ग्रेटर देन आर इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए माइनस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी ಆಗುತ್ತೆ एंड नेक्स्ट वन वेक्टर ए प्लस वेक्टर बी डॉट वेक्टर ए माइनस वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ए प्लस बी इनटू ए माइनस बी फॉर्म मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए होल स्क्वायर माइनस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर एंड नेक्स्ट वन मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए प्लस वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर फार्मूला अली मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए होल स्क्वायर प्लस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर प्लस 2 इनटू वेक्टर ए डॉट वेक्टर बी ಆಗುತ್ತೆ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए माइनस वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए होल स्क्वायर प्लस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर माइनस 2 इनटू वेक्टर ए डॉट बी और मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए प्लस वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर इज प्लस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए माइनस वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 2 टाइम्स ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए होल स्क्वायर प्लस मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी होल स्क्वायर ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस ನ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗೋಣ The cosine of the angle between the vectors. The cosine of angle. अंदरे cos of angle देखा किधर प्रकार था. The cosine of the angle between the vectors. 2i minus 3j plus 6k and 4i plus 8j minus 8k is options one. 16/21. Second one minus 16/21. Third one 15/28. Fourth one minus 15/28. We know that cosine of angle theta here. Vectors are given. Vector A and vector B, which is treated as vector A, which is treated as vector B. You know that cosine of angle theta, that is cos theta, is equal to vector A dot B divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. We know that two vectors are in component form. Then what is the dot product of vector A dot vector B? You know that corresponding components we are multiplying are. So 2 into 4, 8. Minus 3 into 4, 24, minus 24, plus into minus, minus 8 into 6, 48. So remaining, to magnitude of vector A was equal to the root of x square plus y square plus z square. 2 square, 4 plus 3 square, 9 plus 6 square, 36, summed into the root 49. And then square root of, once again, same, square root of 4 square plus 8 square plus 8 square, that is equal to root 144. And we will get simplified. Minus 16/21, that is the option B is the correct answer. The next question, the area of the triangle whose vectors are, the area of the triangle whose vectors are vector A of 1, -1, 2, B of 2, -1, and C of 3, -1, 2 is given by options 1, 4 root 5, options 2, 2 root 3, options 3. Root 13, options 4, root 59. So, area of the triangle ABC is equal to half into required area of triangle with vertices are given. Then the formula is half into magnitude of vector AB cross vector AC. Half into magnitude of vector AB is the line joining AB. 2 minus 1, 1 minus of minus 1 plus 2j. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3k cross vector. Vector A, vector vector AB cross AC, AC is equal to 3 minus 1, 2i, minus 1, minus of minus plus 1 get cancelled, 2 minus 2, 0, I get 2i, I get that. Here we know that vector AB cross vector AC, cross product of these two vectors is half into, cross product of these two vectors is, you know the determinant, I get it, 1, 2 minus 3, 2, 0, 0, and then we have magnitude of cross product of vector AB cross vector -4i -6j are equal, then magnitude of -4k -6j that is equal to square root of 4 square 16 6 square 36 hence root 52 divided by 12 that is simplified to get root 13 hence the root 13 is the option C is correct answer for this question. The next one, if vector magnitude of vector A is equal to 11 and magnitude of vector B is equal to 23 and magnitude of vector A plus vector B is equal to 30, then magnitude of vector A minus vector B is options 1 10, options 2 20, options 3 15, options 4 25. So note the following. First we will find magnitude of vector A minus vector B by using the properties. Magnitude of vector A minus vector B whole square plus magnitude of vector A plus vector B whole square is equal to 2 times of magnitude of vector A whole square plus magnitude of vector B whole square. This implies magnitude of vector A minus B whole square is required. That's same plus magnitude of vector A plus vector B whole square we get simplified. You know that magnitude of vector A plus vector B whole square value simplified manager will get that is the 900 and which implies 2 times of magnitude of vector A plus magnitude of vector B whole square and we required value magnitude of vector A minus vector B is equal to simplified we will get the value is 2 options 2 is the correct answer. Next, the value of I minus j, comma j minus k, comma k minus I is equal to which is the scalar triple product. Scalar triple product of the vector we know that determinant the components of vector A, the components of vector B, components of vector C. Here components of vector A value I na coefficient 1, j na coefficient minus 1, k na coefficient illa 0. Then next components of vector B value I na coefficient illa 0, 1, minus 1 and vector C na components are here minus 1, 0, 1 agirutte is determinant na expand maadidre we know that is equal to we will get the value is 0, options 2 is the correct answer. Then next questions, the sine of angle between the vectors 2i plus j minus k and I plus 2j plus k is 2 by 3 root 3, second one is 1 by 2, third one is root 3 by 2, fourth one is 1 by root 2. I'll give you the question, sine of angle theta, hence the cross product na definition define what for three. Sine theta is equal to magnitude of vector A cross vector B because you know that A cross B part here, A cross B is here. Vector, hence we will take the magnitude divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B, that is therefore vector A cross B is equal to, first we have to find vector A cross B. A cross B know that determinant I, J, K, vector of A, if we have A na coefficient 2, 1, minus 1 and value of vector B na coefficient 1, 2, 1, then we will get simplified 3i minus 3j plus 3k. Then magnitude of vector A plus vector B is equal to square root of 3 square plus 3 square plus 3 square is equal to 3 root 3 and magnitude of vector A is equal to root of vector A value 2 square 4 plus 1 is equal to root 6. Magnitude of vector B is equal to 1 square plus 1 2 square 4 plus 1 is equal to root 6 into root 6. Then sine theta is equal to one by 6 into here it is really magnitude of vector A plus B value is 3 into root 3 divided by into value root 2 6 into root 6 we will get magnitude of vector A value only 6 that is 1 by 6. So 2 1s are 2 3 is a simplified we get root 3 by 2 is the answer is correct. Option C or options 3 root 3 by 2 is correct answer. Next question, the value of P, the value of P for which the vectors 4i plus pj plus 2k and minus i plus 4j plus 3k and 8i plus j minus 3k are coplanar. The moodu vector coplanar are the value of P will be what? Okay, option C is 1, 4, options 2, 6, options 3, minus 4, options 3, 4, minus 6. sir, value of coplanar, we know that what is the condition of coplanar? We have three vectors. We know that scalar triple product is equal to zero. Three vectors are coplanar if the scalar triple product is equal to zero. Now, we have to find the scalar triple product of these three vectors. You know that coefficients of vector A 4, 3, 2 and coefficients of vector B minus 1, 4, 3 and coefficients of vector C 8, 1, minus 3 is equal to 0 and we are expand the determinants, we will get is equal to 0 and simplified we will get the value of P is equal to 6, value of P is equal to 6, answer options 2 is the correct answer. Next question, the area of the parallelogram, the area of the parallelogram whose adjacent sides are given by area of the parallelogram is adjacent sides are given which is vector A 2i minus 3j and which is vector B 2i minus 2j minus k is, then we know that area of the parallelogram is adjacent sides are given by that is vector A and vector B is given by magnitude of vector A plus vector B and the magnitude of vector A plus vector B here vector A value 2i minus 3j plus 2j minus k is equal to, you know that the cross product of these two vectors we will get, you know that determinant of ijk matrix now expand my value sit down that is the 4i cross j minus 6j cross j minus 2i cross k plus 3j cross k then you will get magnitude of 4k plus 2j plus 3i is equal to square root of magnitude 4 square 16, 2 square 4, 3 square 9, root 29. So area of triangle parallelogram is adjacent is given by root 29. Option 1 is the correct answer. The next question. If the vectors 2i plus 3j 6k, 3i minus 4j plus k and 5y minus j plus 7k are the sides of a triangle. Of the triangle is put the three vectors in a size put together. Vector same in the vector A, the vector B, the vector C are the sides of a triangle. That is equilateral or isosceles or right angle triangle, isosceles triangle. We know that already we discussed equilateral triangle and all the sides of vector AB, vector B, vector C is equal in Beku. Isosceles two sides equal in Beku. Right angle triangle, two vectors na dot product maadidre 0 mattu adakke enagirutado vectors two vector perpendicular adu these three vectors are formed right angle triangles. Okay, next we will first we will find magnitude of vector A is equal to square root of magnitude of vector A is equal to 7, magnitude of vector B is equal to root 26, magnitude of vector C is equal to root 25 is equal to root 75. Here magnitude of vector is a magnitude of vector B is a magnitude of vector C is a here magnitude of vector C square is equal to magnitude of vector A square plus magnitude of vector B, thus which forms a right angle triangle which is satisfies the Pythagoras theorem, hence which is forms a right angle triangle. Options 3 is the correct answer. The next questions. If vector A, vector B, vector C not equal to 0, then vector A plus vector B, comma vector B plus vector C, comma vector C plus vector A divided by magnitude of scalar triple product of vector A, vector B, vector C is valued here. If vector A, vector B, vector C not equal to 0, scalar triple product of these vector A, vector B, vector C is not equal to 0, then find the value of vector A plus vector B, vector B plus vector C, vector C plus vector A is options 1, options 2, options 3, 5, options 4, 7. First, we know that using the property vector A plus vector B, vector B plus vector C plus vector C plus vector A is equal to, we define the scalar triple product vector A plus vector B, comma vector B plus vector C cross vector C plus vector A and then vector A plus vector B dot vector B cross vector C plus vector B cross vector A plus vector C cross vector A cross product of these two vectors vector B cross vector C, vector B cross vector A, vector C cross vector C and vector C सी क्रॉस वेक्टर ए ही वेक्टर सी क्रॉस वेक्टर सी वैल्यू 0 सो एक्सेप्ट अल दैट इज इक्वल टू फर्स्ट वी आर अप्लाइंग डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दिस टू वेक्टर वेक्टर ए डॉट वेक्टर बी क्रॉस वेक्टर सी प्लस वेक्टर बी डॉट वेक्टर सी क्रॉस वेक्टर ए दैट इज इक्वल टू रिमेनिंग इज इक्वल टू 2 टाइम्स ऑफ वेक्टर ए वेक्टर बी वेक्टर सी ಆಗುತ್ತೆ देन देयरफॉर magnitude of vector a plus vector b comma vector b plus vector c comma vector c plus vector a is equal to 2 times of 2 remains alayate the value vector a vector b left side bandha is equal to value 2 options 2 is the correct answer the next question if vector a is equal to 3i plus lambda into j minus a vector b equal to 2i plus j plus mu k r orthogonal and magnitude of vector a is equal to magnitude of vector b then the value of lambda comma mu is equal to options 1 minus 31 by 12 comma 43 by 12 and minus 31 by 12 comma 41 by 12 options 3 31 by 12 comma minus 41 by 12 options 4 comma minus 31 by 12 comma minus 41 by 12 you know that two vectors are orthogonal then the dot product is equal to 0 so vector a dot vector b is equal to 0 then the dot product of vector a and b we know that corresponding components are multiplied and sum then is equal to minus 6 we will find the value of lambda square mu square is equal to minus 5 equation 1 and 2 we are solving get the value of lambda is equal to minus 31 by 12 and the value of mu is equal to 41 by 12 options 2 is the correct answer the next question if magnitude of vector a is equal to 4 magnitude of vector b is equal to 2 and magnitude of vector c is equal to 6 and each of the angles between the vectors e is 60 degree then magnitude of vector a plus vector b plus vector c value find out mathematically options 1 is equal to 10 options 2 is equal to 56 options c is equal to root 44 options 4 is equal to 5 here we will find magnitude of vector a plus vector b plus vector c whole square is equal to magnitude of vector a whole square plus magnitude of vector b whole square plus magnitude of vector c whole square plus 2 times of vector a dot vector b into cos theta here cos theta is equal to cos of angle 60 degree cos of angle 60 degree value is 1 by 2 hence which is 2 times of a by 2 1 by 2 plus 3 into 2 times of bc into 1 by 2 plus 2 times of ca into 1 by 2 then magnitude of vector a whole square is equal to 4 square 16 plus magnitude of vector b whole square 2 square 4 plus magnitude of vector c whole square 36 plus magnitude of vector a plus vector a dot b is equal to 8 into 4 plus 12 plus 24 is equal to sum is 100 then magnitude of vector a plus vector b whole square squaring roots take root on both sides and the value is equal to remains then two options one is the correct answer the next question the direction cosines of the vectors 2i plus j minus 2k is equal to direction cosines of the vector vector a is equal to a1i plus a2j plus a3k you know that direction cosines f is equal to cos of y is equal to a divided by square of a square plus b square plus c square and m is equal to cos beta is equal to b divided by square of a square plus b square plus c square and l is equal to square of c divided by square of a square plus b square plus c square here vector a is equal to 2i plus j minus 2k the magnitude of vector a is equal to square of 4 plus 1 plus 4 is equal to root 9 that is equal to 3 hence the direction ratios are 2 1 minus 2 hence 2 divided by 3 comma 1 divided by 3 comma minus 2 divided by 3 hence the direction ratios are options 1 is the correct answer the next the unit vectors in the direction of the vector vector a plus 2 times of vector b minus vector c is equal to vector a plus 2 into vector b minus c divided by root 6 2 times of vector a plus 2 into vector b minus vector c 2 and vector so option 3 vector a plus 2 into vector b minus vector c divided by 4 option 4 for vector a plus vector 2 into vector b minus vector c divided by 6 that vector p is equal to वेक्टर ए प्लस टू टाइम्स ऑफ वेक्टर बी माइनस वेक्टर सी यूनिट वेक्टर इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू बिना दैट वेक्टर बी डिवाइडेड बाय मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी दैट इज इक्वल टू वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू वैल्यू हियर वेक्टर ए प्लस टू टाइम्स ऑफ वेक्टर बी माइनस वेक्टर सी देन स्क्वायर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ 1 स्क्वायर 1 2 स्क्वायर 4 प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू root 6 then the options 1 is the correct answer. The next question if vector A magnitude of vector A is equal to 2 and magnitude of vector B is equal to 7 and vector A plus vector B is equal to 3i plus 2j plus 6k then the angle between vector A and vector B is options pi by 3 options 2 pi by 6 and options 3 pi by 2 options 4 pi by 4 here the angle between the vectors but we have to use sin of angle theta because the given is vector a cross vector b hence sin of angle theta is equal to magnitude of vector a cross b divided by magnitude of vector a into magnitude of vector b that is equal to we know that magnitude of vector a cross b first we are finding given vector a cross b the magnitude of vector a cross b 3 square 9 plus 4 2 square 4 plus 6 square 36 So root value 47 like this 79 14 so I can remaining 14 divided by 7 simplified body will get 1 by 2 then theta is equal to sine inverse of 1 by 2 sine inverse of 1 by 2 given by the angle theta is equal to pi by 6